The Viewpoint is live now.
On Viewpoint tonight is actually to just cut through this entire fiction which has been created. Hectic developments taking place on the Ayodhya front, folks. Truth is this, that there are exactly three players. There are exactly three stakeholders who have to decide whether they are willing to come on one stage and figure out an out-of-court settlement amongst themselves or not. However, what is actually going on is that an environment is being created in the country to make you believe that indeed a solution is possible to the Ayodhya dispute. It's almost as if that solution may be around the corner. A day after representatives of 19 different Muslim organizations conducted a round of negotiations with the founder of Art of Living, Sri Sri Ravi Shankar, is a solution to this long-standing tangle really possible, minus the judiciary? That's a big focus on Viewpoint tonight.
Want to create an atmosphere of fear in the country.
Ram Janmabhoomi par Ram Mandir hi banega, aur kuch nahi banega.
Good evening, namaskar, adab. Welcome to our Friday night special edition of Viewpoint, folks. What we're going to do tonight is present before you nothing else but facts. What's been going on over the last 48 hours in India on a subject which has bitterly divided our polity is nothing short of shocking. What's been going on is this, that there is one big group which has decided to enter the negotiation table, the negotiation rounds, in the long-standing Ayodhya dispute. And along with certain members of certain Muslim organizations, not all of whom are direct stakeholders in this entire Ayodhya battle, a sentiment is being created that different sides, warring sides, have all come together on one table and a solution indeed has been hammered out, and that solution is also acceptable to all the stakeholders. On Viewpoint tonight, straight talk, straight key newsmakers. We've got all sides covered to the story, all people who are directly involved, who are associated with the litigation, who have been a part of this battle over the last three decades, are going to be in front of you. So I appeal to you to be a part of this debate and tell me what you make out. Sharp at 9:45, we'll be throwing up our phone lines open as well. Let's bring you up to speed with developments on that big story on the Ayodhya dispute. Is a solution possible? Big headline number one, 16 leaders from different Muslim organizations. 16 leaders have come together. They've all come together at the specific request of Art of Living founder Sri Sri Ravi Shankar. And after the meeting, one of them, Maulana Nadvi of the Muslim Personal Law Board, has come out and he is saying clearly that Muslims are willing to give up their claim on the site on which the disputed Babri Masjid stood till 1992, till the 6th of December 1992. He says Muslims are going to be large-hearted and they will allow the Hindu parties to come and construct a temple if indeed a favorable climate is created for Muslims in India. What is the definition of favorable climate for Muslims in India is my question number one, which we will be looking on the program tonight. Our big headline number two, and we all know it's not going to be an easy task. Half begun, it's almost looking like it's half undone. Hours after one member of the Muslim Personal Law Board comes out to welcome this negotiation and compromise formula, Zafariab Jilani, convener of Babri Masjid Action Committee, he comes out and he says that this is not a dispute which can be settled in any other way other than the stamp of the judiciary. So if there is no court involvement, there is no solution, says the man who's been leading the entire campaign for reconstruction of a Babri Masjid and punishment for those who were responsible for destroying the Babri Masjid for the last almost three decades. Our big headline number three, and I believe this is where the story really rests. It really is resting on a razor's edge, and there is no other way to describe the story, and that is the politics behind this. We are in 2018, folks. The BJP won the 2014 mandate largely because of Uttar Pradesh. Can a solution to the Ayodhya dispute once again repeat the phenomenal success for the Bharatiya Janata Party, particularly at a time when in independent India's history, for the first time you have a scenario, certainly since the BJP came into existence in 1980, for the first time you have a full majority government of the Bharatiya Janata Party, both in the centre and at the state. So, can this duo of Yogi Adityanath and Narendra Modi, can they ensure that the Bharatiya Janata Party will facilitate the construction of a grand Ram temple in Ayodhya? That's our third big headline. Straight away, let's explain to you what are the dynamics of the story first. It's a story which has been stuck for a very, very long time in different courts. This is the story. This is how the story really exists. We began by being very clear that there are three straightforward players in this entire story. In 2010, the Allahabad High Court gave a judgment. What was the judgment? The judgment was effectively related to trifurcation of the entire 2.77 acres of land. And what was the entire decision about? The Allahabad High Court said in the area around the central dome, one third of that land to be given to Ramlala, which was represented by Hindu Mahasabha. Then it said one third of the land, which is near Ram Chabutra, near Sita Ki Rasoi, it says one third of that land should be given to the Nirmohi Akhada. And it said that the remaining land could perhaps be given to the Sunni Waqf Board, which is just near the entrance point to the site where the statue of Ram Lala today exists in a temple. Now the point is this, that Sunni Waqf Board has not really agreed. It's not agreed to any of these moves which have been made so far to figure out an out-of-court settlement, an out-of-court solution. Sunni Waqf Board is clear they're not willing to look at anything else other than a solution which is given judicial sanctity. What about the Nirmohi Akhada? The other key stakeholder, Nirmohi Akhada, is also clear. It says we are willing to cooperate with any other litigant. But it says the litigant must be a stakeholder. We don't want new stakeholders. So we are ready to cooperate with another litigant in the title suit for temple construction, provided the understanding is that land will certainly be used only and only for temple and for nothing else. Then the third stakeholder, Ram Lala Virajman, Lord Ram himself is also a litigant in this case. The lawyers have taken this position that a litigant in this case contesting to get the temple built can be allowed to enter into negotiations with the other parties, provided again the basic understanding has to be that this land is only and only going to be used for construction of a temple. Babri Masjid was demolished on the 6th of December 1992. But the truth is that suddenly over these last 6 months, despite a range of all kinds of court verdicts which have come, there is a new player which has consistently been propped up by the political class. And that new player is the Shia Waqf Board. Very interestingly, the Shia Waqf Board has repeatedly taken this position that we want the Muslims to give up their claim on that 2.77 acres of land on which the Babri Masjid once stood, and we want the Hindus to construct a temple. What is the Shia Waqf Board all about? Just look at this story. August 2017, the Shia Waqf Board tells Supreme Court mosques can be built near the Mandir. Then a couple of months later, the Shia Waqf Board chief meets the supporters of Sri Siddhi Ravi Shankar. And along with those supporters, he says that we are okay. We are okay with this proposal if the land was to be given away to the Hindus. Then he goes on to say that if there is a grand mosque which is facilitated in Lucknow, we don't have any problems whatsoever. Now, in the month of February 2018, the chairman meets Ram Janmabhoomi chief priests. And having met the chief priest of Ram Janmabhoomi, he comes out and he says those opposing Ram temple can actually go to Pakistan. That is the extent to which one section of the Muslim community, the Shia Waqf Board, has gone to ensure that they can be on the same side as the positions which have been taken by the Bharatiya Janata Party. Right at the top of the program, let's just play all the critical reactions of the key stakeholders. What is the position which is being taken by the likes of UP Chief Minister himself? Let's take a look at this.
सुप्रीम कोर्ट की तरफ से ये कहा गया था कि आप लोग इस मसले को बाहर हल कर लें। हमको चाहिए था कि हम पहल करते, क्योंकि हमें तो इससे पहले ही ये काम कर लेना चाहिए था। 25 साल क्यों गुजरने देते? इसलिए अब हमारा ये कहना है कि एक यूनिवर्सिटी और मस्जिद की जगह मंजूर हो ताकि मुसलमान तरक्की करें तालीमी एतबार से और उधर उस इशू को हल कर लें।
इतने लोग हैं, सबको मैं नकारता हूँ। हिंदू पक्ष से केवल एक है रामलला। राम लला का अधिकार है, राम की जन्मभूमि अयोध्या है, हमारी जन्मभूमि अयोध्या नहीं है, राम की जन्मभूमि अयोध्या है। राम लला का अधिकार है, राम लला का पक्ष है, राम लला की भूमि है। राम लला के नाम पर कल्याण सिंह जी सरकार ने राम जन्मभूमि न्यास को 67 एकड़ भूमि दिया था।
दोनों समुदाय पास आए, दोनों समुदाय के सहमति से भव्य राम मंदिर बने, मगर इसमें मुझे लगता है कुछ समय लग सकता है, 3 महीने 6 महीने लग सकता है। न्यायालय से जो भी होगा वो सबके लिए मान्य होगा, मगर ये एक सुनहला मौका है, अवसर है दोनों पक्ष को पास आके इस मुद्दे को हल करने का, अपना सौहार्द और स्नेह और भाईचारा को दिखाने का।
बोर्ड को इस मसले को नहीं रिकंसिडर करना चाहिए, क्योंकि ये मसला 90 से कंसिस्टेंटली यही हमारा व्यू है। तो कोई वजह हो उसकी तो वो वजह पॉइंट आउट करेंगे, तो बोर्ड देखें, जो कोर्ट का फैसला हो वही माना जाएगा, कोई बातचीत में गुंजाइश नहीं है।
That's where the story really stands. Look at how people have repeatedly taken positions that we are all for the purpose of an out-of-court solution. So we must be very, very clear whether an out-of-court solution is possible purely in the light of facts the way they exist as of now. So let me straight away take a clear-cut position. I believe an out-of-court settlement for Ayodhya dispute is a great idea on paper. Who will detest that and who will deny that? But I say to bring in all the warring sides on one platform is a difficult task. Sri Sri Ravi Shankar has tried his level best by speaking to all stakeholders. He wants to hammer out a consensus, so one wishes him well. But I believe a dispute, which has now been hanging fire for several decades, must necessarily have a judicial stamp of approval to it. If you don't have a judicial approval to it, a judicial sanctity to it, then you know what will happen? What will happen is this, that you can work out any kind of an out-of-court settlement, and that can always be challenged by someone who may claim to be an aggrieved party. In that case, what will be the sanctity of this out-of-court settlement is something that we need to look at very, very closely. Let's see whether our panelists can disagree with my blunt viewpoint as we raise the big blunt question on the program tonight. Is an out-of-court solution possible to this Ayodhya crisis? The great pleasure for me to tell all of you that this is the only program where we've got all stakeholders, all real stakeholders, people who are directly, personally vested with this entire story. Here with us in our studios, Waseem Rizvi, he's the chairman of Shia Waqf Board. Great welcome to him. Along with him, Mahant R.C. Acharya, Mahant Rajaram Chandra Acharyaji, he's a Sarpanch, Panch of Nirmohi Akhada. Karthik Chopra is associate and chief spokesperson of the Nirmohi Akhada. Sharad Pradhan, one of India's foremost journalists who's been tracking the story of Ram Janmabhoomi dispute for several years now. Anila Singh, representing the Bharatiya Janata Party. Atiqur Rahman, well-known Islamic scholar, has been taking strong positions about these out-of-court settlement moves. Mufti Maulana Muhammad Nadeemuddin, he's the president of All India Ulema Council. Big welcome to all of you gentlemen on the program. Let me straight away begin, as we always do, by giving 1 minute each to all our lead speakers. So let me first start with you, Karthik, and let me ask you that direct blunt question. 24 hours back, a meeting takes place at the ashram of Art of Living founder Sri Sri Ravi Shankar. Now in these last 24 hours, an attempt is being made to suggest as if a solution, out of court solution, has already been worked out. Please tell me, where is the Nirmohi Akhada in this?
As far as we are concerned, we will only talk to those parties who are in the title case. As you are aware, the Honorable Supreme Court has yesterday clearly said that they will treat this case as a land title case. Therefore, if we need to speak to anybody, we will only talk directly to the Sunni Central Waqf Board, who is in the land title case. As far as we are concerned, we welcome moves of all other individuals in a bid to create harmony amongst all people. But let's just, if we keep enlarging the scope of entertaining more and more and more and more stakeholders in the title case, we will never see a result. We will never see an end to this situation.
So what's your viewpoint? You are very, very clear that the only way this dispute can be solved is not through Sri Sri Ravi Shankar or anyone like Sri Sri Ravi Shankar, but only and only through the courts, whatever the Supreme Court will decide.
We say we have been fighting in court for so long. We have a very strong case in court. We will pursue this case with all our efforts. We are very confident in our case. But at the same time, if we do have to speak to anybody, we will only speak to the Sunni Central Waqf Board.
You will only speak
which
to
is
Sunni
a party directly.
But what
directly.
About, your, next to you is Mr. Rizvi. Next to you is Mr. Rizvi. Here, he's the chairman of Shia Waqf Board. Rizvi sahab, aap bataye mujhe zara.
Dekhiye, maine Supreme Court mein jo apni baat rakhi hai, main respondent number 24 hoon. Maine party banne ke liye koi wahan pe application move nahi ki hai. Aur Sunni Waqf Board usme respondent number main case jo leading case hai, usme respondent number 22 ya 23 aise hi koi unka number hai. To wo bhi respondent number hai aur hum bhi respondent number 24 hai. Humne court mein ye baat rakhi hai aur us order ko challenge bhi kiya hai ki jo order Sunni Waqf Board se hum hare the usko humne ek appeal ke तहत challenge bhi kiya hai. Dekhiye ye mamla Shia ye masjid Mir Baqi ne banayi thi, humne court mein ye facts rakhe hain aur usme kaha hai ki kyunki ye masjid ka dispute hai to masjid jo hai uska caretaker jo hoga wo Waqf Board ही होगा. और देखिए अभी जो आपकी रिपोर्ट्स मैंने देखी उसमें ये बात कही गई थी कि ये 1/3 सुन्नी वक्फ बोर्ड को दी गई है, ना 1/3 मुस्लिम पक्ष की बात कही गई है. उसी ऑर्डर में सुन्नी वक्फ बोर्ड के रजिस्ट्रेशन को खारिज भी
But
किया
गया. But I have gone through the entire judgment, sir. Nowhere does it say that Shia Waqf Board is a stakeholder. Nowhere does it say. जो इलाहाबाद हाई कोर्ट का जो ऑर्डर है उसमें तो ये कहीं मेंशन नहीं है कि
Shia Waqf Board ने उसमें कहीं पे भी अपना जवाब दावा दाखिल नहीं किया.
But what does that mean? That is the point that I'm trying to make, Karthik. And I think it's important for all our viewers to understand this. So here is Mr. Rizvi. He is the chairman Shia Waqf Board. आप बातचीत कर रहे हैं श्री श्री रविशंकर से, आप बातचीत कर रहे हैं राजनीतिक नुमाइंदों से, एंड कार्तिक, इट इज नॉट क्लियर वेदर ही हैज इज अ स्टेक होल्डर और नॉट. सो हु इज ही देन? हु इज मिस्टर रिजवी टू बी स्पीकिंग ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ शिया वक्फ बोर्ड और ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ मुस्लिम्स? मैं नो कार्तिक,
is he a stakeholder? Number who
is he a stakeholder?
The respondent number 24 main
we
case
are only mein. Going by the record.
Yeah, yeah, respondent
as it exists in our title case
24 of yes. The to kya mujhko ikhtiyar nahi hai
in the title case?
Yes,
and he is not there.
Is he there? Kya ye hai?
We don't see him
ye
there.
Kehte hain he is respondent number 24 in which case? In the case which
suit
is there
number 5
before the Supreme Court.
Yes,
not before the Allahabad High Court. That's what I'm trying to say. So please be clear, folks, please be clear. You are looking at a scenario where an attempt is being made by an individual party to now become a part of this case when they have not been included in that judgment which was given in 2010 by the Allahabad High Court. Atiqur Rahman, please explain to me when Mr. Rizvi, right, in his capacity as chairman Shia Waqf Board, says that I am now trying to become a party. So therefore, please hear me out. And therefore, if he says that I'm willing to share my land, if I'm willing to give my land to the Hindu community, that's the viewpoint of the Muslims. Is that something which goes for you? Is that something which works for you?
Mr. Rizvi is a big rod in the spinning wheel of all the arguments in the Supreme Court. He has been, you know, given the green signal by the Sangh elements so that whatever the judgment is coming, that judgment pronounces a very difficult posture outside in the society. And people fight over it, and clarity is, you know, diminished in all this. You know, I would say that as there are three parties in the Supreme Court, there are three issues also. The three issues are, as the Supreme Court yesterday pointed out, only the title suit. Second is the Aastha. And third is the ASI findings. Now these three elements, my friends, you'll have to very carefully go around all these three elements. Unless and until the Supreme Court is pronouncing something. So now since the Supreme Court has said that they will be going only by the title suit, there are goosebumps into the Sangh elements.
Dekhiye, title suit hai. सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने ये बात कही,
ठीक,
हम उसमें एक पक्षकार हैं.
आप बनना
नहीं,
अरे आपकी पिटिशन एक्सेप्ट हो गई, मैं मानता हूं, लेकिन उसका ये थोड़ा मतलब हुआ कि
नहीं 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 नहीं
ये फैसला दे दिया कि आप उसके हिस्सा में, ये नहीं समझ पा रहा मैं।
प्लीज, हम उसमें, हमने जब काउंटर एफिडेविट दाखिल किया था तो कोर्ट ने कहा कि आप इसमें पार्टी हैं, हमने कहा हम रिस्पोंडेंट नंबर 24 हैं, तो कोर्ट ने कहा ठीक है, उसको रिकॉर्ड पर लिया, तो रिस्पोंडेंट नंबर 24 होने के नाते हम उसमें एक पार्टी हैं, हमने ये बात कोर्ट में,
सर, इफ आई गो टू द सुप्रीम कोर्ट, इफ आई गो, प्लीज एक्सप्लेन टू मी, इफ आई गो टू द सुप्रीम कोर्ट एंड इफ आई से दैट आई एम एसोसिएटेड विद लॉर्ड राम बिकॉज ऑफ माय सेंटिमेंटल अटैचमेंट, दैट डजंट मीन दैट आई स्टार्ट क्लेमिंग ownership of the land.
Absolutely.
on which there is a sentiment that there was a temple which existed.
The sentiment is for all Hindus. But when it comes to ownership, अपनी बात complete करने के लिए
बताएं बताएं
जब मैंने सुप्रीम कोर्ट में अपनी बात रखी है तो सुप्रीम कोर्ट को उसको डिसाइड तो करने दीजिए।
बहुत अच्छी बात है, मैं भी तो ये कह रहा हूँ, मैं भी तो ये कह रहा हूँ, शरद प्रधान प्लीज एक्सप्लेन टू मी नाउ, मिस्टर रिजवी सिंगिंग अ डिफरेंट ट्यून. Now, Mr. Rizvi is saying, I have approached the Supreme Court. Please let the Supreme Court decide. I am saying exactly the same thing. I am saying let the court decide.
But he does not become a party.
How is Shia Waqf Board becoming a party to this entire case? Let's settle this case first and foremost. Sharad Pradhan.
You know, Mr. Waseem Rizvi had been sleeping all along and suddenly wakes up to a realization that he is a party to the case. Obviously, there is enough reason from his entire, the way the Shia Waqf Board has been going about it in the past 1 year, is very evident that they have some axe to grind with the BJP. And Mr. Waseem Rizvi has many skeletons in the cupboard, and that is the reason BJP has been able to use him for this purpose. It's very obvious. You know, it is very simple. An out-of-court settlement will certainly not be acceptable to the parties who are involved. Right. No matter Shri Shri Ravi Shankar and all these people who have nothing to do with the case that was on which the verdict has been passed by the Allahabad High Court. They are meaningless. You know, and the Muslims in general, to them, an out-of-court settlement is not acceptable for the simple reason that is going to open the Pandora's box for other such shrines where the Hindus have been staking claim, which is Mathura and Kashi. So obviously they would prefer, you know, in their heart of hearts, I can tell you, most of the people who are party to the case, including the Shia Sunni Waqf Board, they would be happy to hand it over to the Hindus if there's a court verdict. You know, on the contrary, the Hindus have made it loud and clear that right or wrong, this way or that way, the court verdict will be acceptable only if the verdict is in their favor.
That's
so
all
that's
argument.
Like a sharp difference.
Can I just hold on? There is a statement.
For an out-of-court settlement, so that they can drive home.
We've just got one reaction from one of the members of the Muslim Personal Law Board, who was also a part of these negotiations which were being held at the instance of Sri Sri Ravi Shankar. Just take a look at what Maulana Nadvi has to say about all these moves which are being made for an out-of-court settlement.
सुप्रीम कोर्ट की तरफ से ये कहा गया था कि आप लोग इस मसले को बाहर हल कर लें, हमको चाहिए था कि हम पहल करते, क्योंकि हमें तो इससे पहले ही ये काम कर लेना चाहिए था, 25 साल क्यों गुजरने देते। एक जमीन अगर वहां 70 बीघा है, 70 बीघा जमीन दूसरी जगह होगी, तो मेरा ये कहना है कि हमारे यहाँ जो तसव्वुर कॉन्सेप्ट है मस्जिद का, कि मस्जिद में स्कूल होना चाहिए, तालीम का निज़ाम होना चाहिए, इसलिए अब हमारा ये कहना है कि एक यूनिवर्सिटी और मस्जिद की जगह मंजूर हो ताकि मुसलमान तरक्की करें तालीमी एतबार से और उधर उस इशू को हल कर लें।
नदीमुद्दीन साहब, आप बताएं मुझे, योर प्रेसिडेंट ऑल इंडिया उलेमा काउंसिल, यहाँ पर देखिए नदवी साहब कह रहे हैं, नदीमुद्दीन साहब की बहुत अच्छा है, आप अपनी जमीन जो है हमको मुसलमानों को छोड़ देनी चाहिए, वहां पर आप एक भव्य मंदिर बना लीजिए। बात तो बहुत लोग कहेंगे कि शायद ठीक कह रहे हैं कि मुस्लिम समुदाय के सामने अनेकों ज्वलंत समस्याएं हैं, क्यों नहीं उन समस्याओं से निपटने के लिए कुछ और सोचा जाए, बजाय इसके कि आप सिर्फ मंदिर मस्जिद के विवाद में आप फंस रहे हैं। क्या मानेंगे नदीमुद्दीन साहब की जो कह रहे हैं ये नदवी साहब, क्या ये सही है कि आप इसको एक्सेप्ट करेंगे?
देखिए, मौलाना सलमान ने क्या कहा ये उनका निजी विचार है, निजी राय है, मुसलमानों को इससे लेना देना कुछ नहीं है। देखिए,
तो किससे लेना देना है?
और वसीम, हाँ, देखिए सुनिए, ये मामला सुप्रीम कोर्ट में है, एक पक्ष के लिए आस्था है, हमारे लिए न्याय है। मस्जिद तोड़ी गई थी, और उस वक्त के नरसिम्हा राव ने, उस वक्त के प्रधानमंत्री ने कहा कि वहां मस्जिद बननी चाहिए। अब मामला सुप्रीम कोर्ट में है, सुनिए पहले बात, सुप्रीम कोर्ट को क्या फैसला करना वो तय करेगी। एक बात, वसीम रजवी का रोल ऐसा ही है जैसा कि सर्कस में एक जोकर का रोल है। वसीम रजवी को छुपाने के लिए
की, तो ये मैंने कोई मजाकिया बात की थी कि जिससे आप मुझे जोकर दिखाई दे रहे हैं या हम आपको जोकर दिखाई दे रहे हैं?
क्यों जोकर नहीं,
क्या
नहीं?
सुनो, अगर मैंने कोई बात सुला समझौते की, साहब मैंने विवाद को खत्म करने की बात रखी है, वो भी सुप्रीम कोर्ट के सामने रखी है। और अगर के सुप्रीम कोर्ट के सामने अपनी बात रखना,
बोलिए तो नदीम साहब,
जोकर का काम है।
नाराज क्यों
है आप? क्यों हमको ऐसे टारगेट करते हैं? अगर इनका क्या ये जोकर का काम है कि वो अपनी राय सुप्रीम कोर्ट में रखे?
क्या
सुप्रीम आप, तो आप सलमान नदवी साहब ने अगर अपनी बात रखी तो क्या वो जोकर थे?
मिर्ज़ा साहब सुन लेते हैं, पर्सनल कमेंट पर्सनल ना हो, कृपया पर्सनल ना हो, अपने अपना पक्ष रखें, पर्सनल ना हो।
वसीम रजवी अपने पापों को छुपाने के लिए
देखिए मौलाना साहब, इज्जत करना सीखिए। अगर आप इज्जत करोगे तो आपको इज्जत मिलेगी, अगर आप इज्जत नहीं करोगे तो आपको भी इज्जत नहीं मिलने वाली। ये गलत बात है। आप जैसे लोग ही मुसलमानों को बदनाम कर रहे हो अपनी जाहिलियत से। आप मौलवी नहीं हो, आप जाहिल हो। आप जैसे लोग जब जबान खोलते हैं तो दुनिया देखती है कि मुसलमानों का चेहरा क्या है।
थोड़ा संयम बरते।
अरे बेशरम आदमी हो,
बेशरम आदमी हो। देखिए
शेर सुनिए रिजवी साहब का,
तुम भी पले हो आले नबी के टुकड़ों पर, नमक हलाल हो तो नमक हलाल की बात करो।
देखिए
और कहां मस्जिद के मांगने वाले, कभी तो जन्नतुल बकी की बात करो।
देखिए ये स्टेक होल्डर, एक सेकंड, लेट्स
जन्नतुल बकी अगर के, देखिए जन्नतुल बकी अगर तोड़ा गया तो मौलाना साहब,
नदीमुद्दीन साहब एक मिनट,
आपने कभी उसका ऑब्जेक्शन किया?
सुने तो रिजवी साहब एक मिनट, मैं नदीमुद्दीन साहब से ये पूछना चाहता हूँ कि आप देखे ना मुस्लिम समुदाय के सामने समस्याएं क्या है, क्या गलत कह रहे रिजवी साहब? अगर रिजवी साहब ये बोल रहे हैं कि साहब आप एजुकेशन की बात करें, आप रोजगार की बात करें मुसलमानों की, तो क्या गलत कह रहे हैं? आपको उसमें गलत क्या लगता है? आपको नहीं लगता मंदिर मस्जिद के विवाद से आगे बढ़िए ना?
ठीक है तो आप बढ़िए ना, मैं कह रहा हूं कि मुसलमानों की मस्जिद गिराई गई तो आप जो है आप बढ़िए, आप फराख दिल होके कहिए कि वहां मस्जिद बना लो। आप कौन होते?
अरे आप एक बात भी मस्जिद की लड़ाई लड़ लो, जन्नतुल बकी गिरवा दिया आपने, कब बात है उसकी की? कितनी मस्जिदें ट्रांसफर हो चुकी है? जन्नतुल बकी के अंदर मस्जिद बनी थी वो तोड़ दी गई, आपने कब सवाल उठाया?
दैट इज अ होल प्रॉब्लम, दैट्स अ होल प्रॉब्लम।
रजवी आज तुम्हारी अकल आई, आज तुमको मालूम हुआ कि जन्नतुल बकी में मस्जिद है?
मौलाना साहब,
लेट मी जस्ट टर्न टू महंत राजा राम जी।
मामला सुप्रीम कोर्ट में है, सुप्रीम कोर्ट जो फैसला करेगा मुसलमान
सुप्रीम कोर्ट का सहारा लेकर हिंदुस्तान में आग लगवाना चाहते हैं, ये सुला समझौते की बात करना ही नहीं चाहते।
एक सेकंड महंत राजा राम जी, एक मिनट महंत राजा राम जी, देखिए पूरा देश इस वक्त, पूरा विश्व आज देख रहा है कि किस प्रकार से मुस्लिम समुदाय आपस में एकजुट नहीं है। मैं ये जानना चाहता हूं मुस्लिम समुदाय आपस में एकजुट,
मगर हिंदू समाज एकजुट है क्या?
है क्या?
आप एकजुट हैं क्या? हिंदू समाज एकजुट है क्या?
एक सेकंड, आ रहा हूं, सबके पास आ रहा हूं, पहले जरा महन जी की सुनो,
कुछ तो तहजीब रखें।
जरा आप ये बताएं कि आप निर्भय अखाड़ा से
रखी है ना?
आप सुनिए,
लैपटॉप ऑन द फील्ड डाउन।
महंत जी, मैं सिर्फ मेरा विनम्रता पूर्वक सवाल बस इतना है कि मुस्लिम पक्षकारों के बीच तो देखिए जो विरोधाभास है ये हम देख रहे हैं, क्या आपको लगता है कि जो हिंदू पक्षकार हैं, जो हिंदू जो जो बाकी जो लोग हैं, क्या वो लोग एकजुट हैं इस पूरे मसले में कि उनमें भी विवाद है?
देखिए, हर व्यक्ति अपने अपने मगज को लेकर के अपने आप में वो रह सकता है। जहाँ तक राष्ट्रीय समस्या का प्रश्न है, धार्मिक दृष्टि का प्रश्न है और भूमि विवाद का प्रश्न है, इधर न तो राम जी की लड़ाई है न अल्लाह मियाँ की लड़ाई, सिर्फ सुन्नी सेंट्रल बोर्ड वकफ और निर्मय अखाड़े के बीच की तकरार है और ये कोर्ट में हो जाए, ये कोर्ट में निर्णय हो जाए, वही आवश्यक
जो कोर्ट में जो निर्णय हो जाए। तो लेट मी हियर दिस लाउड एंड क्लियर, लेट मी हियर दिस लाउड एंड क्लियर, एंड आवर प्रोड्यूसर्स कैन पुट दिस एज बिग ब्रेकिंग न्यूज दैट व्हाट यू आर सेइंग कार्तिक अलोंग विद द हेड प्रीस्ट ऑफ द निर्मोही अखाड़ा दैट दिस एंटायर काइट फ्लाइंग दैट्स गोइंग ऑन राइट नाउ इन इंडिया इज कंप्लीटली काइट फ्लाइंग। यू आर नॉट गोइंग टू एंटर इनटू एनी नेगोशिएशन विथ श्री सी रविशंकर और एनीवन एल्स, यू आर ओनली एंड ओनली गोइंग टू गो बाय द वर्डिक्ट ऑफ द सुप्रीम कोर्ट।
This gentleman here has been fighting this case for the last 70 years. Correct. He wants to see justice in his lifetime, as do everybody involved with this case. We have finally arrived at the Supreme Court. When the hearings were on the 5th of December, the other party said that they wanted this issue postponed after the 2019 elections.
Right.
Yesterday, when we were in the Supreme Court, they wanted day-to-day hearings. In the court itself, they are not, their stand is not clear whether they want to go with the
Sunni Waqf Board. When you say the other party,
the other parties,
yes.
Right?
The Muslim parties.
Yes, the Muslim parties. They must make their stand clear that when they are in court, do they want to move fast in court or do they want to delay? That's one. Secondly, if we do have to talk to anybody, we will like to talk directly to the Sunni Waqf Board.
Not
through any mediation.
Not through Sri Sri Ravi Shankar, not through anyone else.
Not through any mediation, and we invite the Sunni Waqf Board to come and have direct discussions with us if they have something to say and they have any proposal for us.
Rahman
sir, else we are very happy in court.
Mohammad Nadeemuddin ji, क्या आप ये मानेंगे कि देखिए कार्तिक चोपड़ा जी का जो प्रपोजल है कि साहब आपस में ही बैठ के बात कर ली जाए ना, एक पक्ष इनका है, एक पक्ष आपका, एक पक्ष सुन्नी वक्फ बोर्ड का है और एक पक्ष भगवान रामलला विराजमान का है, यही तीनों पक्ष आपस में बैठ के चाय पे चर्चा करके क्यों नहीं समस्या का समाधान कर लेते?
देखिए, इससे पहले बहुत मरतबा बैठे, बैठने के बाद रास्ता का समाधान नहीं निकला। मेरा कहना है कि एक पक्ष के लिए आस्था है, दूसरे पक्ष के लिए न्याय है, न्याय और आस्था का झगड़ा है। मैं कहता हूं कि सुप्रीम कोर्ट में मामला है, आप अब होते कौन है, अब सुप्रीम कोर्ट को फैसला करने दीजिए, दोनों पक्ष मान जाएंगे।
आई गेट योर पॉइंट, आई गेट योर पॉइंट। सो व्हाट यू आर सेइंग,
दिस इज अ व्यू पॉइंट ऑफ समबडी नॉट इन द केस।
या सो बट आई एम जस्ट ट्राइंग टू अंडरस्टैंड,
देयर आर पॉजिटिव व्यूज दैट पीपल शुड मूव फॉर सॉल्यूशन, देयर आर नेगेटिव व्यूज।
ऑन वन एंड वी प्रेफर टू गो विद पॉजिटिव, व्हिच बिलीव्स दैट इट हैज अ राइट टू बी अ पार्ट ऑफ दिस केस बट इज एक्चुअली नॉट अ पार्ट ऑफ दिस केस। There is a Sunni Waqf Board which believes that it has to wait for the verdict of the Supreme Court. You've heard from the Nirmohi Akhada. Therefore, let me turn now my attention to the political parties. Anila Singh, your spokesperson of the Bharatiya Janata Party, ma'am, your chief minister in UP, Yogi Adityanath, made it very clear. The day when Sri Sri Ravi Shankar was in Lucknow and Ayodhya, I was there with the chief minister. I was there with Sri Sri. And Yogi Adityanath ji made it clear that there is no way any out-of-court settlement is possible. Do you believe courts are the only way out for this long-standing dispute?
Bhupen ji.
Yes, go ahead, ma'am.
I would like to state here what Mark Twain had said once, that... It is a lot easier to mislead people rather than to convince them that they are misled. This is what is happening right now. Few organizations or few people, they are trying to twist the whole case and they do not want any sort of settlement. Though Justice Kehar, Justice Chadjur and Justice Kaul, they had asked for out-of-court settlement because this case is very, it is full of sentiments and it is a very sensitive case. This is what they said. So like if somebody is trying to get the whole thing settled out of court, so they are, you can say that they are doing something what these three justices had asked. So we should not put question mark on them. But definitely whole case is sub judice, and we are waiting
no,
for the judgment
is
for the verdict to come.
This is the case. This is the case, ma'am, which has been a dispute right since 1950 when Gopal Singh Visharad first filed a suit in the Faizabad Civil Court. But my point is, on one hand, Mr. Rizvi, Chairman Shia Waqf Board, is sitting right next to me, and there are you. Chairman Shia Waqf Board says the land could be given to Hindus. The BJP's viewpoint is that there must be construction of a Grand Ram Temple. If I was to say that actually behind this entire scene, it's the BJP game plan which is being played out to somehow ensure, that there can be a temple which can be constructed. Would I be right?
Absolutely not. And like Supreme Court said that we are not going to give the decision on faith or on the sentiments, and we are going to going to argue on the basis of the title of the land. Exactly. If we talk about that, then also I do not have
Sharad
any doubts about
what's
it,
the reality,
that the land will be given.
We are in February 2018, Sharad Pradhan,
for the construction of temple, because
Sharad
initially
ji,
it
what
was
is the reality,
Sharad
ji?
From
the more,
Hindus.
The
yeah.
more
yeah.
I look at
there
Dr. Chopra, and that's why I've got all the stakeholders. Yeah, that's why I've got all the stakeholders. I've now got a clear-cut viewpoint from
the
Nirmoya
Thana.
I'm just saying, Sharad ji, I was asking Anila Singh whether this entire move of bringing in Sri Sri Ravi Shankar, bringing in these 16 Muslim representatives, had the backing of the BJP both in UP at the center. Is this entire move of so-called out-of-court settlement being propped up by the BJP only and only because you have elections probably this year or next year?
But three justices wanted that, Bhupen ji.
You are absolutely right. You hit the nail on the head.
Yes, sure.
There is reason to believe that. There is reason to believe that because elections are around the corner, and this is the only way that BJP is hoping to regain the majority that it got in 2014. That is Narendra Modi's style. And this is that's very, it pays the BJP huge dividends if they succeed in getting the temple through by any means. So, and they know that the court process is going to take longer. That is the reason they have created this environment, and they are propping up people who are talking about an out-of-court settlement when they know, what is the hitch? You know, what is the hitch in waiting for the Supreme Court verdict?
Yeah, if you wait,
the Supreme Court takes its time. That
is
how
the
judiciary of the country moves.
Anila Singh, why not wait for it,
Bhupen ji, I have a simple question from Sharad ji, that does he agrees or not that when Mir Baqi snatched away this land from the Hindus and he demolished the temple to get the mosque constructed, it was unauthorized demolition, wasn't it?
So what's that got to do with it? So what's that got to do with
another point? In 1986,
in a civilized society,
it was such a trauma.
There is a Supreme Court. There is a
that trauma is still continuing till date.
Anila
Singh, let the Supreme Court decide that. You and I cannot decide that. Let the Supreme Court decide that.
Absolutely. I agree with you.
The matter is before the Supreme Court, and there is no reason.
Sir, I agree with you.
You know, can you, there is a counter question, Anila Singh.
Yes. Go ahead.
No, Anila Singh, there is a counter question. Will you tell me, will a verdict going against the Hindus be acceptable to the BJP if the Supreme Court gives a verdict? Tell me that.
Anila ji, answer the question.
I ask you, is it okay with you? Do you think morally, legally, don't you think that Ram Mandir should be constructed there?
Yes, any judgment, any verdict.
I am saying very boldly.
No, his point is any verdict.
That is not the
His point is Supreme Court verdict.
Respect the court.
Supreme Court verdict. So let's go by the Supreme Court verdict.
Whatever the verdict comes, Sharad ji, whatever the verdict comes, we have to stand with it.
That's all.
So the same question goes. So the same question goes.
No,
from
I am specifically asking
well.
You.
So
because Muslims have time and again
court
said
gives the verdict,
that
they should,
any verdict
they should
even
agree
if it
to
goes
it.
Against
they should
be acceptable to them.
This was influenced by Bharatiya Janata Party.
I think we're getting a very clear picture. I think we're getting a very, very clear picture of what's actually going on. Of what's actually going on. Let me just put that question to Atiku Rehman Saab also. Rehman Saab, you know, while you say that there must be a Supreme Court order, let me take the same question that Sharad Pradhan was asking Anila Singh. What if this order, and I don't want to be pontificating about what Supreme Court will do or will not do, but what if the order is not in your favor? Will that be acceptable to you?
Definitely, you know, Bhupenji, time and again, the Muslim side has said that we are waiting for the verdict eagerly, and whatever it is, whether it is in favor of them or it is against them, they will be binding by the Supreme Court. Now, the problem is the other side is not at all agreeing to it. And then they talk of consensus.
So what is the, you're saying that the other side, which is a Hindu side, which is the Nirmohi Akhada, which is sitting right in front of you, or Ram Lala Virajman, their starting point is that there must be a temple. And your starting point for any negotiation is there must be a mosque. Therefore, let's be clear, even if these three sides, Sunni Waqf Board, Ram Lala Virajman and Nirmohi Akhada were to come together, the possibility of any compromise doesn't exist, Kartik Chopra. Are you willing for any kind of a scenario where you will cede your right over that land on which there was a temple?
Look, we have a very strong case. We welcome the comments of the honorable gentleman who just said that if the Muslims lose the case in court, Mr. Rehman, they would be very happy to hand over the land to us. We welcome that, and we have a very strong case, so we're very happy to hear that. At the same time, like we said before, if the Sunni Waqf Board is willing to, wants to unconditionally speak to us and have some discussion with us, we've always been open to this. But we will continue to fight in court.
You will continue to fight.
Definitely,
in court.
Because
irrespective of what
we
happens.
Have been fighting in court for decades.
So Rizvi saab, fir zara mujhe bataye na ki ye jo pura jo masla jo chal raha hai, jo ki Srisi ji keh rahe hain ki bhai sab log aa gaye, aap keh rahe hain ki saab wahan se masjid ko hata ke Lucknow mein masjid bana lijiye, aap keh rahe hain saab ki koi favorable climate bana diya jaye, ye kya hai sir?
Dekhiye, maine jo baat kahi hai, मैंने उसमें सुप्रीम कोर्ट में उन बातों को भी रखा है कि मैंने ये किस आधार पे कही है. मीर बाकी ने बनाई थी, शिया मस्जिद थी, 1528 से लेकर 1944 तक शिया एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन रहा.
ठीक है,
44 में जो इनका रजिस्ट्रेशन सुन्नी वक्फ बोर्ड का था वो इनवैलिड डिक्लेयर हो चुका है. हाई कोर्ट ने भी कहा है और सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने दोषी पूरा वाले केस में उस रजिस्ट्रेशन को सुनिए, सूट नंबर 5 में इशू नंबर 19
पढ़िएगा.
अनजाने की शादी में अब्दुल्ला दीवाना, तो इनका यही आलम है रिजवी साहब.
शरद
आपको
दिखाई दे रहा है, मैं आपसे कह रहा हूँ कि आप हाईकोर्ट का ऑर्डर पढ़े. हाईकोर्ट का ऑर्डर, अगर हाईकोर्ट के ऑर्डर में ये बात सेटल ना हुई
हो,
हमने पढ़ा हुआ है.
When the structure was demolished, BJP was not in power. Right. Why are you always targeting the ruling government? There have been different governments, such cases have been going on.
You're right. But for the first time since the BJP came into existence as an independent political party since 1980, you have a scenario where you have a full majority government both in the center and the state of UP. Therefore, this question must be asked. Since the BJP committed itself for the construction of a Ram temple, this question must be asked. This is the best possible scenario for the BJP. Yeah. The best
and
possible
location. Came to power from 2 seats to an absolute majority.
Therefore, can I just ask this question to wrap up this discussion? Firstly, starting with you, Maulana Nadimuddin Saab.
And we will remain like that.
Maulana Nadimuddin Saab, seedha sawal aapse poochta hu. क्या आपको किसी भी प्रकार
का That's your obduracy, ma'am.
कोर्ट के बाहर one moment. क्या आपको किसी भी प्रकार के कोर्ट के बाहर की नेगोशिएशन मंजूर है क्या आपको नदीमुद्दीन साहब?
देखिए, हो ही नहीं सकता. मैं कह रहा हूं कि बातचीत से मसला हल हो ही नहीं सकता.
नहीं,
तो मंजूर होने नहीं होने का क्या सवाल है? मामला सुप्रीम कोर्ट में है. आप सुप्रीम कोर्ट को जो फैसला है करने दीजिए.
पॉसिबल नहीं है कार्तिक,
हम कोर्ट में लड़ते रहेंगे. पर अगर हमने बात करनी है, हम डायरेक्टली सुन्नी सेंट्रल वक्फ बोर्ड से ही करेंगे और किसी से नहीं करेंगे.
जी, आपको अपना पाप धोना है, पाप धो लो.
अरे हमारे को कोई पाप आप नहीं धोने जनाब.
वो कार्तिक चोपड़ा
ने बोला, तुम्हारा पाप बहुत है, अपना पाप धो लो.
हमारे कोई पाप नहीं है.
रिजवी साहब,
किससे बोल रहे हैं
वो? एक मोमेंट, रिजवी साहब स्पीकिंग.
देखिए, मैंने कोर्ट के सामने ये बात रखी है कि ये सुन्नी प्रॉपर्टी नहीं है, शिया प्रॉपर्टी है, और हम तो नहीं चाहते मैं नहीं चाहता कि वहां पर विवाद आगे बढ़े, वहां पर मंदिर बन जाए।
नो वेयर इन द इलाहाबाद हाई कोर्ट जजमेंट इज इट स्टेटेड, नो वेयर इन द इलाहाबाद
और कहना चाहता हूं प्लीज कि इस प्रोग्राम को दुनिया देख रही है
जी।
हाई कोर्ट का जो जजमेंट आया है उसमें सूट नंबर 5 में इशू नंबर 19 में अगर के सुन्नी वक्फ बोर्ड का रजिस्ट्रेशन को इनवैलिड ना कहा गया होगा,
यहाँ पर सब लोग जितने लोग बैठे हैं
सुनिए, अगर इनवैलिड नहीं कहा गया होगा तो आज के बाद से शिया वक्फ बोर्ड की तरफ से ये कभी क्लेम नहीं होगा।
झूठ बोल रहे हैं,
ये कभी क्लेम नहीं होगा।
जेंटलमैन
मैं ओपनली कहता हूं आज के बाद से कभी क्लेम नहीं करूंगा।
दे हैव टू सॉर्ट आउट द मुस्लिम साइड मस्ट बी क्लियर ऑन वन प्लेटफॉर्म।
आप झूठ बोल रहे हैं आप
नदीमुद्दीन साहब।
अरे आपको मालूम नहीं क्या यार, हम झूठ क्यों बोल रहे हैं? आप पहले पांच
I think we got a clear picture. As I thank all of you for joining us on this special edition of Viewpoint. I think we got a clear picture that Srisi Ravi Shankar or anyone else has a very, very tough and long road ahead. It's a dispute which started off way back in 1950, the first time when a petition was filed before a civilian court in India. It's 2018, folks. Till now, what has not been achieved through the courts, can it be achieved out of courts? Well, you have seen what is the possibility. According to me, the possibility is extremely bleak at this stage to work out any kind of an out-of-court settlement. Let's take a break. A lot of viewers asking us a lot of questions. I'm waiting to hear from you. Our phone lines are open. On the other side, the interactive section, the viewers' viewpoint. Tell us if you believe, in light of what you have seen today on Viewpoint, do you believe an out-of-court settlement is still possible? I'm waiting to speak to you on the other side of the short break. Welcome back, folks. I'm waiting to hear from you. I've just put this on my Twitter as well, 0120-434-1895. That's the number on which you can call me and you can tell me if you agree or disagree with my viewpoint. My viewpoint is simple. I don't believe that an out-of-court settlement is indeed possible to the long-standing, vexed Ayodhya dispute. Vaseem Siddiqui is our first caller who's joining us. Vaseem bhai, thank you so much for tuning in to Viewpoint. Aap bataiye, what do you think? Do you agree with me that an out-of-court settlement not possible?
Definitely. The point here is, like, if the Supreme Court is saying, like, out-of-settlement can be done, Supreme Court itself is running from its responsibility.
Hmm.
So there is no scope of out-of-court settlement. 27 years have been passed. So many people have been killed. Supreme Court should take an initiative and do the, like, you know, come up with a the decision which should be accepted by both all three parties.
Are you saying, Vaseem ji, that actually the Supreme Court believes the Chief Justice of India, because this case is before the Chief Justice of India, are you saying the Chief Justice of India believes that any decision which should be taken by the Supreme Court may not be taken favorably by the party which may end up being the losing party?
Definitely. And this holds true especially with the other two parties which are constantly, upfrontly, they're claiming that, you know, we are not going to accept any decision which goes against our favor.
Okay, Vaseem ji, thank you so much. Keep tuning in to Viewpoint. Keep watching us and keep being a part of our Viewpoint family. Sunil Raghavan is joining us live as well from Mumbai. Sunil bhai, thank you so much. Tell me, what did you make out of the show? Do you agree? Do you agree with the viewpoint that I have stated on the program tonight?
Well, partly, but I feel that there can be an out-of-court settlement if both parties agree. And Dr. Subramanian Swamy, I've been watching his debate in the erstwhile program, not in your channel, but other channels also.
Right.
He has given an out-of-court settlement that there should exist a Ram temple because there is a birthplace of Lord Rama.
But, you know, Sunilji, the problem, Sunilji, and that's why the channels that you were referring to, I just want you to know that there is a lot of fiction and kite flying which is happening. The problem is one more. Hear me out. I'm saying Swamy himself, Sunilji, Dr. Swamy himself is not a party to this case as yet. So he is arguing this case just like you and I can argue.
We've just had the spokesperson of the Nirmohi Akhada, which I'm sure you must have seen. Nirmohi Akhada, Sunni Waqf Board, Bhagwan Ram Lala Virajman. Between these three people, these are the three stakeholders. Do you believe an attempt is somewhere being made, perhaps keeping in mind the next Lok Sabha elections, to somehow try and expedite this process of out-of-court settlement? So is there politics behind it?
See, there may be politics, political parties, they may use this issue to their advantage. But as you said that Dr. Subramanian Swamy is not a party to it, then why did the Supreme Chief Justice given the task to him to mediate between the two factions?
That's just like Sri Sri Ravi Shankar is attempting to mediate on his side. Subramanian Swamy perhaps is also being expected to play a constructive role. Thanks very much, Sunilji, for joining us. Indeed, it is true. It is true that who would not like it if an out-of-court settlement could be worked out. But you've seen on the program tonight just how difficult the task is. Chandrasekhar is our next caller. Chandrasekhar is joining us from Chennai. Chandrasekhar ji, thank you so much for watching Viewpoint. Welcome to our Viewpoint family. What do you believe, sir? Do you believe this Ayodhya dispute can be solved by talking outside the courts?
Good evening to you all. You see, we have already a partition problem with Pakistan, India partition. Like that, you should not have the out of settlement is always better. If you go by the court, the loser will definitely take a revenge on the other fellow. That will be a bigger, another problem going to start.
Okay.
It's better we all should insist on all the three parties to sit together and solve the problem in the interest of the country.
All right.
We are on the one hand talking about development. On the other hand, you are talking about infighting, getting into the problems of infighting,
all right,
like a partition.
Chandrasekhar ji, may I only request you to keep watching Viewpoint each night and keep giving us your feedback about what you think of the positions that we take on the program. Thanks very much, Chandrasekhar ji, for joining us on Viewpoint tonight. So, folks, on Twitter, those numbers are up. I'll put those up on my Facebook timeline as well. It's an earnest appeal to all of you. Tell us what you think. Let's make an interactive experience. Let's get to know of each other. Let's figure out whether you agree with the statements that we make, the questions that we raise. If you disagree with me, you do not like something that I may have said on the program, please give me constructive feedback. I'll try and match up to the expectations that you may have out of us here. So then, let's turn our focus to our hero, villain and ridiculous section. Who's the hero of the day? Each day we give you a hero of the day. Hero of the day is a very interesting choice. My favorite cricketer, Virender Sehwag. Sehwag doing what he's always done, hitting big sixes. Five big sixes in the Swiss Alps. Where else? Virender Sehwag knows how he can hit sixes, whether he's on a cricket ground in Feroz Shah Kotla or Melbourne or Lords or in the Swiss Alps. Every hero each day, unfortunately, produces a villain as well. And who's the villain? Villain, ladies and gentlemen, is the education system in India's largest state of Uttar Pradesh, where each day, while class 10 and class 12 exams are on, the number of students who are simply dropping out of this exam process has been increasing at an alarming rate. The latest news coming in from UP is that 12 lakh students have dropped out of facing mathematics examinations at class 10 and class 12 level. Can you believe that? 12 lakh students have dropped out. What does it tell you? It tells you that if there is no cheating, which is allowed in India's biggest state, then students just don't want to be facing up to examinations. And who's the ridiculous of the day? Ridiculous of the day, folks, is an individual belonging to a community which should actually be described as heroes each day. But you know who that person is? You know who's that picture and what is he doing? We've got a special package for you, which has been prepared by my colleague Shreya Dhondia. Just look at that.
It was just another day in Parliament. Starched white dhotis, band galas, files in hand. And then walked in the TDP contingent, led by, of all people, a tantric. The stage was set and the drama started.
I will show in my manner, you know.
I will tell you, sir.
But TDP MP Siva Prasada wasn't done with the theatrics yet. Every time a mic popped up, he propped up an encore.
You are dressed as Lord Venkateshwara Swami to prove a point.
No, Venkateshwara Swami came to me.
and bedwad karukuruma ke so okay
and what did he tell you
huh
what did the lord tell you
yeah they have to inform Modi to be careful
Siva Prasada a trained doctor turned actor turned politician is a serial headline grabber in the hallowed halls of parliament he has shown up wearing ghungroos and holding a musical instrument This he put to good use as his party protested in the well of the house demanding a special package for Andhra Pradesh. The TDP is accusing its ally the BJP of cheating it out of a promised financial package to tide over its bifurcation votes.
In the presence of Venkata Balaji Swami, he promised so many things. In the presence of Kanaka Durgamma, he promised so many things. And he has forgotten everything. So we are cautioning him.
Shiva Prasada's roles range from grand to absurd. But his cause has always been Andhra Pradesh. Before the state was bifurcated, he stunned parliament dressed as Lord Krishna, wearing a crown, garland and even a Sudarshan Chakra. Chided for his behavior by the chair, he later took a lash and whipped himself several times in front of television cameras right outside the house. Even a suspension from the Lok Sabha couldn't keep the two-time MP from Chittoor down. Depending on the season and his moods, he has changed his look. An MP is the upholder of Parliament's decorum and dignity. In an attempt to gather attention for his cause, has MP Shiva Prasada reduced both to a joke?
And if you want to know more about how the drama was unfolding in and outside Parliament today, Shreya Dondial has an unmissable program lined up for you at 10:30 p.m. tonight. If you want to know how MPs can be extremely irresponsible, you and I may find it entertaining, but I would say that it's extremely irresponsible. But there is one person up next, as I thank all of you and hand you to my able colleague Mare Shakil, who's having a rather good time. Are you just enjoying these pictures, Mare?
And I loved it. Actually, it was very hilarious. It was actually very hilarious.
So give us a good laugh.
But how about you cracking a joke and making me laugh?
Well, I thought what the parliamentarians were doing was extremely joke.
That was actually laughable.
That wasn't that laughable.
But tell me,
what's the big thing about laughter these days in Parliament?
No, but the problem is that because I don't giggle and I believe in a hearty laugh. So tell me, does my laugh offend you, Bhupendra?
I'll join you in your laughter, Maria.